Mannahouse Kids, we are back for another week of epic fun.
It's going to be so much fun, it's so exciting, messy, and most of all, it's going to be important.
Oh man, I'm so excited, let's get to it.
But first, let's go to our values. Value number one is to
know Jesus. And value number two is another really important one, and it is to
make friends. Woo! Value number three is to
have fun.
Woo! And value number four is
be safe.
Awesome.
Oh man, I'm so excited to be safe and have fun.
Yes.
And you know where we can practice both of those really well?
Where?
In game time.
Woo! Hey, Mannahouse Kids, we are so excited because today we have a blast from the past. What we're going to be doing is recreating an experiment that Stephanie did in the past where she put Mentos in Coca-Cola. We're making sure that we're being really safe. That's why we have our nice cap on. We laid out a tarp so it doesn't get everywhere. And if you guys want to do this at home, make sure that you guys ask a grown-up and go outside and do it so it doesn't get your house all messy, right, Luke?
Yep, I'm so excited.
All right, what do we need?
So what do we need? We need some Mentos because Mentos is important. We have some type of Diet Cola because Diet Cola works the best. Then we have a small plate just for the looks of it because it looks fancy.
Yes, we do.
And then we need some safety hairnet.
We got that.
We got our tarp all set out.
Yep.
Ready to make a mess?
We're ready.
Let's go.
Okay, so first we're going to take the lid off of this Coca-Cola here. And we got to make sure we have our Mentos ready. So we took the top off. We have our thumb here, so it's ready to dump it in when we're after we take the cap off.
All right. Cap is off and ready to go. All right. You got it, Aisha?
I got it.
Let's go. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Oh.
Make sure it doesn't explode everywhere yet. We want to save
like nice
that
cola.
For later.
All right. So then the next step is you can take your Mentos, and we have already taken off the top, but make sure that you just do a little bit of ripping off the top. Make sure it's like a nice tube, so that way it can all go in at
once.
So
excited. Are you ready for this? This is going to be amazing. Are you guys ready for the explosion of your lifetime?
All right, so make sure your finger's over the top. Put it right over the bottle. And 3, 2, 1, go.
Ah!
Ah! Whoa! It's not a rain, it's a fountain.
That was so cool.
It's everywhere, on my shoes, in my hair. Oh, I love it, wow.
Yes, that was so much
fun. Man, this is so good. Man, this actually-
Mine's still going, look.
What?
How? It's like a flowing river.
The plate did its job. All right, wow. This actually reminds me a lot of today's lesson where Jesus did not stay dead. He's actually alive!
Awesome. Well, let's go into our memory verse and then we can go into our lesson.
Hey, Mannahouse Kids. Okay, guys, you know what time it is. It is memory verse time. So I need you to stand up on your feet, stretch it out. All right, here we go. Our memory verse is found in John chapter 11, verse 25. The first time, I want you to listen really close. The second time, I want you to repeat it after me. And the third time, we're gonna do it all together. Here we go. John 11, 25. It says, I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will not die, but live. Did you get it? Okay, now we're gonna do a repeat after me. You ready? John 11, 25. I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will not die, but live. Okay, last time we're gonna do it all together. Are you ready? Give me one big stretch because we have to jump. I wanna see you jump as high as you can. Can you touch the ceiling? I think some of you can. Are you ready? All right, here we go. John 11, 25. I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will not die, but live. Good job, you guys. Okay, I want you to practice this memory verse during the week, and I will see you next time. Bye.
the Savior's love, I have been made new. I can live a day, I can live without you. Running towards the light, leave my past behind. Never going back, Jesus, you're alive.
Hey, Mannahouse Kids. Okay, guys, if you are watching this online today, I know that you've just seen some crazy epic explosions. We worshiped a little bit. If you're watching this at your campus, I'm sure you're having fun. But today's lesson is so important. I want you to lean in and listen real close. Today, we're going to talk about the Word of God. Pop quiz. What is my name? Did you get it right? Do you know? Okay, my name is Deb. It's okay if you didn't know my name. Now, I want to ask you a question. What's your name? Yell it out. Wow, that was a lot of names. Okay, well, I want you to think for a minute. How important is a name? I mean, can you imagine if we lived in a world and nobody had a name? What would you call them? Right? Names are so important. Names help us identify who someone is, or maybe even what they do. If I said Scott, someone probably came to mind. Or if I said John, you probably thought of someone. Or maybe Allie, right? Well, names have a meaning. They're ways we identify ourselves and others. Our names not only have a meaning like of how we identify ourselves, but our names have an actual meaning. For example, my name Deborah means bee, which is kind of weird, but it also stands for a woman in the Bible who was really strong and really courageous. If your name's Isaac, did you know your name means laughter? All of our names have a meaning. If you don't know what it is, I want you to ask your parents because I think it might surprise you. Well, today our lesson is called My Name. I want you to repeat it after me. Say, My Name. All right. Well, let's jump right in. I need you to grab your Bible. We're going to turn to a passage in the Bible. If you don't have a Bible, that's okay. I want you to write this down because later this week, I want you to read this. We're going to go to John chapter 20. You also can find this lesson in Matthew 28, but we're going to focus on the John 20 lesson. So last week, we learned about Jesus being crucified on a cross. He died and he was put in the grave. Now, I know that Jen talked a little bit about what that looks like and how he didn't stay dead. But today, we're going to talk about the best part of this story, Jesus's resurrection. So we're going to go to John chapter 20, and I'm going to read this to you. So listen in, get ready. If you need to stretch a little, go ahead. All right, here we go. On the third day after Jesus' death, Mary Magdalene went to Jesus' tomb. It was still dark, and she saw that the large stone at the entrance had been moved away. Mary ran to Simon Peter and John. "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and I don't know where they have put him," she said. Peter and John ran to the tomb. John looked inside and saw the linen cloths lying there. Then Peter went into the tomb and saw the linen cloths too. The cloth that had been around Jesus' head was folded up. Jesus had good manners. I just want to point that out. John believed that Jesus was alive. Then Peter and John went back home. Mary went back to the tomb and cried. When she looked inside, she saw two angels sitting there. They said to her, "Woman, why are you crying?" "Because they've taken away my Lord, and I don't know where they've put him," she said. Then Mary turned around. Jesus stood in front of her, but she did not recognize him. Jesus said, "Woman, why are you crying? Who are you looking for?" Mary thought Jesus might be the gardener. She replied, "Sir, if you have taken Jesus away, tell me where you've put him, and I will go get him." Jesus said, "Mary." Mary realized who he was and said, "Teacher." Jesus sent Mary to tell the other disciples that he was going back to the Father. Mary did what Jesus said, and she told the disciples, "I have seen the Lord." Okay, I want to take a closer look at the obvious person in this story, but I think there's something about this person's life that really relates to you and I. Let's talk about Mary for a minute. You see, Mary was close to Jesus. You could even say Jesus was very important to Mary. In our story, we hear about Mary going to visit Jesus at the tomb. Now, let's think about this. We have read over and over in our Bible how Jesus told the people he was going to die and he was going to be raised from the dead. But what does Mary do when she gets to the tomb and she sees it empty? She freaks out. Where did he go? Somebody must have taken him. Well, we find her crying, thinking that someone has stolen Jesus's body. This point of the story reminds me a lot of us sometimes. Mannahouse Kids, we've been to church. We've read the Bible. We've heard the stories. We've watched the Mannahouse Kids show. But how many times are we in a situation and we know the answer, but we start getting all worried and we start getting stressed out and we get really anxious or afraid? We know the answer. We know what Jesus has done for us. But sometimes we can just feel alone. But when Mary turned around, Jesus was standing there. But even then, Mary didn't recognize him. Sometimes we can get so focused on the wrong thing that we don't even see Jesus right in front of us. We don't even see the answer in front of us. But do you know what Jesus said to Mary? Mary didn't recognize him, and Jesus didn't say, hello, it's me. Or, are you crazy? Have you lost your mind? You don't recognize me? We've spent a lot of time together. No, Jesus said one word to Mary. What was it? He said her name. He said her name. And it was at that moment that Mary recognized who Jesus was. You see, Mannahouse Kids, Jesus didn't stay dead. He rose from the dead. He rose from the grave. And he didn't just call Mary by her name, but did you know that Jesus calls you by your name? He has a purpose and a plan for your life. He didn't say, John, I just created you and I'm going to leave you there and never come back and never talk to you again. No, Jesus rose from the dead so he could call you by your name. You have a destiny. And it's when he calls our name that we really see him for who he is. Jesus died on the cross because he is crazy about you. He loves you so much that he wasn't going to leave you broken or crying. Or alone, or afraid. No, Mannahouse Kids, Jesus rose from the dead because he loves you and he knows you. So maybe you're watching this today. Maybe you knew what Jesus did. Maybe you've heard this story 100 times, but you're like Mary and you're running to the tomb and you see it empty and you've forgotten what Jesus has done for you. Or maybe you're like Mary and Jesus is standing right in front of you, but you can't recognize him because you've never heard his voice before. Mannahouse Kids, today he would call you by your name. So I want to give you a chance. We're going to pray together. I want to pray for 2 things. For those that have forgotten just how awesome Jesus is, just how much he loves you. We're going to pray for that too. If you've never asked Jesus into your heart, if you've never heard him call you by your name, he's calling you today. Let's pray together. Everybody bow your heads, close your eyes. Jesus, thank you for dying for us. Thank you that you didn't stay dead. Thank you that you show us in your word people that we can relate to. God, thank you that you call us by our name. Forgive us for our sins. We ask you into our heart today. We love you. Be with us forever. Amen. Amen, Mannahouse Kids. Hey, if you prayed that prayer for the first time today, I want you to tell either your leader or your parent or your grandparent. I want you to tell someone because they want to celebrate with you. But here's how we're going to close today. On the count of 3, I want you to yell out your name. Okay, are you ready? 1, 2, 3. Awesome, Mannahouse Kids. Jesus is calling you by your name today. I know he has the perfect plan for your life. You can trust him. Love you guys. I'll see you next time.
This week's lesson was so much fun. It was so messy and also really interesting.
Man, it was so awesome. And I'm so glad to hear that Jesus did not stay dead. He rose again.
And that brings us to our question of the week. What hope does Jesus' resurrection give you?
Man, that is a great question. Right? I know that because of Jesus' resurrection, I can no longer fear death.
Take some time this week to talk to your parents about how this lesson spoke to your heart.
Man, that is such a great idea. Anyways, we will see you next week. Bye!